Has the OPR had any occurrences where they had to shut down any of the injection wells? And if so, where?
If an injection well pressure, those annular spaces that we monitor, if those go out of balance, they might be positive pressure, they might give back in the pressure. If those go out of their prescribed range, then what we do is require the company to shut down, run what's called a mechanical integrity test. And anytime those pressures are exceeded in the vacuum or in the pressure state, the companies are automatically told to shut the well down. If a company exceeds their maximum injection pressure, which is continuously monitored, we give them an administrative order, and these orders are required by federal law, so they automatically get an order to shut the well down. We evaluate the well, we run mechanical integrity on it to make sure its condition is sound. So yeah, we do that fairly often. Of the 177 wells, I won't be able to give you a where, but in our files we show you when we do them.
Okay. I have a question that says to actually educate myself. It's my understanding that when the waste is injected, it's injected to the depth of the sandstone strata, generally speaking, and that the sandstone being permeable would then absorb like a sponge, hypothetically, the waste of liquid that has been injected. So my question is, once you put in an injection well, which works perfectly, and you inject the liquid waste down to the depth of the sandstone, and then you believe that you have that expected process that the sandstone begins to absorb all of that waste, when you have a given site, let's say a 2-acre site with the permits permission, does that waste that's being absorbed by that sandstone continue on beyond the parameters of the boundary lines of that permit?
The basic answer is yes. When the wastes are pushed down well, they're pushed down under pressure, they're not absorbed, they simply are pushed through the permeable and porous spaces within the rock itself. So they're stored in the rock and then they're pushed out of the mountain out. And they're pushed out kind of in an ellipse, not a circle, but kind of an ellipse shape in most cases. But yeah, they can't go beyond a lot, for example. And what we can do to calculate how far they might go out is calculate the porosity permeability of the rock, the thickness of the rock, the injection zones itself, there might be multiple injection zones, and then the volume and pressure to get an idea of how far out that fluid might travel.
Thank you. The next question is, they noticed that there was a class 1 injection well in the city of Mansfield. And actually, I know where it is, and they wanted to know if there was any evidence, or was there any study, or was there any indication that this class 1 injection well, which is down by Baldwin Street, was there any contamination of water, or has there been any indication that there has been contamination of water?
I won't be able to answer that for you. The different classes of wells that are regulated by either Ohio EPA through primacy agreement, USEPA, or ODNR with that same kind of agreement. A class 1 well is a chemical waste well. Some of them are classified as hazardous. They take chemical waste from manufacturing and other chemical processes, and they dispose of those wastes. Those are regulated by Ohio EPA. So I'm sorry to say you're not familiar with that class 1 well.
The next question, I don't know if anybody is.
I'd like to know why there are no injection wells to dump this waste in Franklin County.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Good one, good one.
I don't live in Franklin County, but I live in Stark County.
There one by your house?
There are quite a few. The companies decide where they feel they can locate a well, in part on geology and in part on economics. So those factors and other factors are used to determine. There's very little production in the area of Franklin County in the area of Columbus. Most of the production is in a line from about Mount Vernon and east toward the Pennsylvania line. So the majority of the wells are either in the central part of the injection wells, or in the central part of the state, or east. But there are a scattering of them even in the western line. It's mostly based on economics and geology.
So it's simply saying that in our community here in Mansfield, we feel, and we let the dean already understand where we're coming from, we're very concerned about this new industry, which is going to be apparently a tremendous industry, which really started in many ways in 2008. But we're concerned because it could compromise the quality of our water, structure of our homes, reputation of our community, stability of our land. These are very, very issues to us. So in that regard, it seems very important to the mayor and to our council and to certainly our office that a local community would be able to preserve its right to test what's being injected to into its injection well in its community. In other words, assuming hypothetically that the state of Ohio, the federal government, have the right to determine where wells may be, we would like to preserve our right to say we will appoint our own people, our own county, to test each and every tanker car or trailer that comes in to inject this waste fluid. It would seem to me that if there's no concern about the toxicity of that liquid, then there should be no objection to allow us to test it.
Yes.
At the expense of the company that's going to have
yes, yes, yes.
Please tell us from an engineering standpoint one single reason why a local community should not be able to test its own liquids that are